This is Oscar from Tertio Gaming, and I've got the Nintendo Switch, and I'm all pumped up for a new adventure playing The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. It's going to be amazing. I also have Super Bomberman R and 1-2 Switch and Snipper Clips, which I bought digitally in the eShop. That's going to be amazing with my wife. But meanwhile, we're going to play Zelda, of course. Oh, new updates available. Okay, download it. All right, so the update's downloaded. Let's go with my Luigi profile. I'm so excited. I already have the expansion pass, which for me was free. Yeah, I was gifted it in the game store. Because I'm a big spender. Yeah. Here he goes. Nintendo presents The Legend of Zelda. Breath of the Wild. Really somber, isn't it? Nice sparky spark. Ooh, don't tell me that the game is going to start immediately without going through the main menu. And open my eyes. Okay. Yep, the game is starting without a main menu.
Open your eyes.
Okay, I'm opening them. Don't worry, Zelda.
Wake up, Link.
I'm doing that. Oh god, this is... Okay, so Link wakes up in this resurrection chamber. After sleeping, I think, for 100 years. Don't know what happened in the past, but we'll find out. Alright, so we can control Link already. There you go, we can run around, the camera, we can move it.
That is a Sheikah Slate. Take it. It will help guide you after your long slumber.
Can I pick up the barrel? I can. Can I throw it? Oh, I dropped it. I can push, which, yep, spends stamina. It has physics, it doesn't go in a predetermined path, which is nice.
Oh, I don't have a weapon. I don't have a weapon. What's going on? I don't have a weapon. Right.
Link,
oh, wow, it's so bright.
You are the light. Our light. That must shine upon Hyrule once again. Now go.
Oh, a stone, a rock, let's push it. Oh, don't want to crouch, don't crouch, don't crouch. There we go, just push it down. Maybe we kill the old man with this. Oh no, old man, run! It's dangerous to go alone, take this. Is that a rotten apple? It's a baked apple. He baked it next to the fireplace.
I beg your pardon, I do believe that is my baked apple. You can't just go about taking whatever you please. Forgive me, I couldn't resist pulling your leg. Please help yourself. An apple in an open flame make for a succulent treat. According to legend, this is the birthplace of the entire kingdom of Hyrule.
So, probably it's kinda like Skyloft? Okay, he's pointing. Pointing over to the Temple of Time.
That temple there, long ago, it was the site of many sacred ceremonies.
Let's pick up the axe. Woodcutter's axe. Let's link the apple capture. Whatever, okay. I just can't seem to reach that apple, not even climbing, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna chop this tree. Chop it down. Chop it for the apple. Go. Yeah. Chop down a tree just for its apple, that is... that is cruel. I'm gonna get that sword, whatever that is. Oh, a Korok!
Yeah, you found me! Huh? You're not Hestu. But you can see me. I didn't know your kind could see the children of the forest. Well, if you run into Hestu, please return this to him.
Hey, that's a southerner Korok. Hillbilly Korok. Korok seed. This small seed was given to you by a Korok. It has a distinct smell. If you gather a bunch of them, you never know what may happen.
Oh, and my friends are hiding in lots of different places too. So don't be shy about poking your nose into suspicious places.
Okay, hillbilly Korok. It's a wooden sword. Rusty broadsword. Oh, this once fearsome sword has seen better days. It can do some damage in the right hand, but also breaks quickly. So let's see which does more damage. It seems that the broadsword... Yeah, froggy, froggy, froggy. Yeah, froggy, froggy, froggy. Yeah, you... Oh! How did he jump so high? Yeah, froggy, froggy, frog... Alright, he's gone. Ooh, our first combat with a bokoblin. Take that. Oh, I got a traveler's bow from this chest, which is nice. I can draw my bow using the trigger, and I release to fire. Let's retest it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. I can use the gyroscope even to aim, which is really nice. It actually reminds me of the Steam controller. That in some games you also use the gyro sensor to aim. Nice views. Ooh, this is like the bell tower. Oh, we got a chest here. Soldier's bow. Wow, that's much better than the bow I had. I can also change the bows. Alright. I need to be drawing the bow to actually change it. There we go. We got the soldier's bow equipped now, which is better. So this is the first objective. Right here. First I'll take down this guy. Hey mate. Yeah, take a whacking. Take a whacking. Oh, he left a shield. Get up. The shield, bucko shield. To raise my shield, I have to use the left trigger. And he left a traveler sword. And here's the objective. Looks like a Sheikah shrine. Right out. Please watch for falling rocks. Falling rocks? Oh god. Oh god. Oh god, what's happening? Everything is shaking. What the hell? Those are tower things. Okay, that was weird. And I'm on top of this tower. Great Plateau Tower. Alright. Who calls? Oh crap, it's the old man!
My, it would seem we have quite the enigma here. This tower and others just like it have erupted across the land, one after another. It is almost as though a long dormant power has awoken quite suddenly. You do not mind me asking, did anything odd occur while you were atop that tower? Heard a voice, I suppose? Well now, a voice you say. Do you happen to recognize this mysterious voice? No. I see. Well, that is unfortunate. I assume you caught sight of that atrocity enshrouding the castle. That is Calamity Ganon. 100 years ago, that vile entity brought the kingdom of Hyrule to ruin. It appeared suddenly and destroyed everything in its path. So many innocent lives were lost in its wake. For a century, the very symbol of our kingdom, Hyrule Castle, has managed to contain that evil, but just barely. There it festers, building its strength for the moment it will unleash its blight upon the land once again. It would appear that moment is fast approaching. I must ask you, courageous one, do you intend to make your way to the castle? Suppose so? I had a feeling you would say that. Here, on this isolated plateau, we are surrounded on all sides by steep cliffs with no way down.
you were to try to jump off, well, no death could be more certain or more foolish. Of course, if you had a paraglider like mine, that would be quite another story. Hand it over? Certainly, why not? But there is no such thing as a free item in this world, you know. Let's see now. How about I trade it for a bit of treasure that slumbers nearby? Do you see that structure there? The one shining with a strange light? Yup, that's a Sheikah shrine. Began glowing at the exact moment those towers rose up from the ground. I would think such a place might house some sort of treasure, wouldn't you? Treasure for the paraglider. Fair exchange, I believe. Well, it depends on the treasure, mate. I mean, if the treasure is better than the paraglider, then you can keep your paraglider, that's for sure. Anyway, let's hit the Sheikah shrine. Do it!
Sheikah slate confirmed. Opening the Sheikah shrine. Please step in the mysterious circle. Your gate registered to map. Access granted.
Mysterious robot voice. Okay, so I'm excited to see what this Sheikah shrine has for me. To you who sets foot in the shrine, I am Oman Ao, and I completely disregarded the message. Magnesis trial. Oman Ao shrine. Okay. Magnesis. Rune extracted. Manipulate metallic objects using magnetism. Grab onto metallic objects using the magnetic energy that pours forth from the magnesis rune. Objects held in the magnetic snare can be lifted up and moved freely. Okay. I can put them wherever I want. This is amazing stuff. I can use the gyroscope. Look at this. I can slam it against the ground. Yeah. Alright, so I'll just leave it there. And I'll just move this one as well, just to get it out of the way. Let's see what's underneath. Okay, so I suppose I have to cross to the other side, but to do that, I'm going to use the magnesis here to pick up this metal part. Come on, up you go. And I'm going to move you over here to create another bridge. And let you there. There we go. This is magnificent. I like it.
You have proven to possess the resolve of a true hero. I am Oman Ao, the creator of this trial. I am a humble monk, blessed with the sight of Goddess Hylia, and dedicated to helping those who seek to defeat Ganon. With your arrival, my duty is now fulfilled. In the name of Goddess Hylia, allow me to bestow this gift upon you. Please, accept this spirit orb.
And he gives me a spirit orb. Whatever it does, I don't know. But it just went inside me, and it's spooky. Spirit orb, symbol of courage given to those who have overcome the challenges of a shrine. Okay. I don't know what kind of treasure the old man wanted, but maybe the spirit orb? Hey, mate.
It seems you managed to get your hands on a spirit orb. Well done.
How did you know?
Clairvoyance. Oh, or perhaps just something similar.
One gets older, it can become more difficult to see what is right before one's own eyes. However, that which was once hidden from you can often be crystal clear. But perhaps that is not true for everyone. Appearance of those towers and the awakening of this shrine. It is all connected to that Sheikah slate you carry on your hip there. Paraglider, please.
I have yet to finish speaking. Long ago, a highly advanced tribe known as the Sheikah inhabited these lands. The great power of their wisdom saved this kingdom time and time again. But their ancient technology disappeared long ago, or so it is said. These shrines are tucked away in numerous places all across this land. This plateau alone, I believe there are still three more. Bring me the treasure from each of those shrines and I will give you my paraglider.
Dude, that wasn't the deal. Oh, well, I suppose I changed my mind. I'm sure that won't be a problem for a young go-getter like you. There's a shrine. And there's another one. And there's the final one. Okay, let's get to work. Let's assault these guys. Can I shoot that thing? I think I can. Oh yeah, pure destruction in there. Okay, let's finish them off. Hey mate. Ouch, 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 that hurt a lot. Oh wow. Yeah. Now what is that? Oh no, please. It's a guardian that's awake. Behind the structure. There we go. Jabide Shrine. Remote bomb. A bomb that can be detonated remotely. Nice. So we're gonna try these new ruins. So here we have some cracked walls. Let that actually change to the... What is the difference between square bomb and round bomb? No idea. Nope, no. That's not how you do it. That's how you do it. So, out a bomb. And detonate. Nice, nice. I like it.
Your resourcefulness in overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of a hero. In the name of Goddess Hylia, I bestow upon you this spirit orb.
The second spirit orb. Let's get going. Let's see. Let's cook. Hold them. Let's add 2 mushrooms and 3 spicy peppers because I like my food nice and spicy. And with that, we're going to cook them in the pot. Spicy fruit and mushroom mix. Grants low-level cold resistance. This dish contrasts the sweetness of fruit with the savouriness of mushrooms. For 8.5 minutes. So I'm going to eat this before entering the cold area. Okay, it's starting to get cold and I'm taking damage, so it's time I eat this. Yeah, nice and hot. Alright. 8.5 minutes of resistance, so I have to hurry up. Now let's see, to actually cross this river, what I'm going to do... No, not this. I'm going to try and chop down these trees here. So that the current takes them down downstream. And it makes a pathway for me. Oh, and a woodcutter axe. There we go. Cut them down. And make a path out of it. Let's cross on the log. There we go. Come on. Get to the other side, Link. This way. Ain't time to get off. There we go. Uh-oh. I'm hurt and I better eat. And I better change weapon as well. Ooh. Take him down. Ooh, simple goblins. Hello there. Oh, missed. Oh, missed again. Wow, they're throwing barrels. Right. Ouch, 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 ouch. My throwing spear is in a bad shape, and me as well. I need to eat. I got some meat here, though, that I can take. Kenamut Shrine. New rune, the Cryonis, builds ice pillars that are very stable. Yay. Alright, let's try that out. So I can freeze the water and create some pillars here. Oh, I can decide the height. Nope, not that big, but anyway, that'll do. I'll climb it, and done. So, I'm assuming that I can lift this gate up with a Cryonis. Yep. I assumed correctly. And that's the third spirit orb.
Oh, come on. Oh my god. So pathetic. No! Open it. You know, I might as well just build blocks until the end so I can just get out of here. Okay, I'm running out of cold resistance, so what I'm going to do is take out a torch and see if the torch will help me resist. No, don't put it out, Link. Please don't put it out. Please don't put it out. Okay, I'm leaving the fire. Now with a torch. Torch keeps me warm. Oh, there's some boulders. I'm gonna keep with the torch. Keep with the torch. Keep me warm. Oh, so at the top of Mount Hylia, we actually have the old man. Hey, a mate. It's cooking. Ah, I enjoy gazing out at the world from here. Breathtaking view. This may be the best place to get a full view of the entire plateau. You just scope to look for shrines. When you locate one, place a pin on your map as a marker. You did well to make it this far without the proper clothing. Please take this warm doublet as a reward for your tenacity. Nice, give me cold resistance. I really need that. Is that actually enough to withstand the cold here? Right now. There we go, it did lower the cold resistance. Oh yes, now I'm fine. You know what, I'm actually going to try putting pro mode. Just take out the minimap and the interface to make it more realistic. Yeah. Beautiful. Next shrine. Down there. And last shrine. Let's get in there. Stasis, stop the flow of time for an object. I have to stop the cog. Alright, there we go. Perfect. And it has time. Haha, I didn't know that. Alright. Traveler's shield. That is a much better shield. Ooh, what's that? That's a sexy sledgehammer, isn't it? Oh my god, 12 damage. Oh yeah. Oh, I can hit it. Okay. So it's like accumulating all the force. And that's gonna blast off. Yeah, that's amazing. I like it. And fourth spirit orb. Yay. Where are you, old man? Oh, how about you give me the paraglider now, huh? With this, you have now acquired all of the spirit orbs from the shrines on this plateau. Extraordinary. That means it is finally time. Link, it is finally time for me to tell you everything. But first... Imagine an X on your map, with the four shrines as the endpoints. Find the spot where those lines intersect. I shall wait for you there. Do you understand? Where two lines connecting the shrines would cross, there I will be waiting. Yeah, I kinda think I understand. So we got all the shrines here. Yeah, that's the last time I died. So they kinda intersect. And this one here. At the Temple of Time. So I've been to most places of the plateau. I've been to Mount Hylia and I've been to the frozen place, and I've been here and I've been there and I've been here, but I haven't been to this Forest of Spirits thing, and I think I'm gonna check it out before leaving the Great Plateau. Yeah, that took care of those Stalfos. Ooh, and mushrooms. Oh, keys! Keys! The hell? Oh, it's that guy from when I seen the gameplays and stuff! Oh! Oh! I think you have to actually climb on this guy. Yeah, and hit that stone thing that he has there. Oh, I think I can take him down. Hold on. Let's bring up the sledgehammer. Bring him up. Bring him down. The stone talus. Bring him down. I actually saw El Rubius fight this thing. Oh yeah. And yeah, lots of items. Amber. I just don't know what amber is for at the moment. And ruby. Companion shield. And key swings and everything. I'm just gonna pick all of this. So here I am at the Temple of Time, and I see that the goddess statue is glowing for some reason. You who have conquered the shrines and claimed their spirit orbs, I can offer you great power. It appears you have claimed 4 spirit orbs. In exchange for 4 spirit orbs, I will amplify your being. So tell me what it is that you desire, a heart container or stamina vessel? I think I'll go with the heart container because this game is very punishing. Yes. I shall grant the power you seek. Give me another heart container. Oh yeah, 4 hearts. Give it to me. Nice. Extra one now.
Well done there, young one. Now then, the time has come to show you who I truly am. I was King Rome Bosphoramus Hyrule. I was the last leader of Hyrule.
Okay, you have the same face as the king from Wind Waker, so I guess. Oh shit, look at that.
The Great Calamity was merciless. It devastated everything in its path, Lo, a century ago. It was then that my life was taken away from me. And since that time, here I have remained in spirit form. I did not think it wise to overwhelm you while your memory was still fragile. So rather than that, I thought it best to assume a temporary form. Forgive me. I think you are now ready. Ready to hear what happened 100 years ago. To know Calamity Ganon's true form, one must know the story from an age long past. The Demon King was born into this kingdom, but his transformation into malice created the horror you see now. Stories of Ganon were passed from generation to generation in the form of legends and fairy tales. But there was also a prophecy. The signs of a resurrection of Calamity Ganon are clear, and the power to oppose it lies dormant beneath the ground. We decided to heed the prophecy and began excavating large areas of land. It wasn't long before we discovered several ancient relics made by the hands of our distant ancestors. These relics, the divine beasts, were giant warriors. We also found the Guardians, an army of mechanical soldiers who fought autonomously. This coincided with ancient legends oft repeated throughout our land. We also learned of a princess with a sacred power, and her appointed knight, chosen by the sword that seals the darkness. It was they who sealed Ganon away using the power of these ancient relics. 100 years ago, there was a princess set to inherit a sacred power and a skilled knight at her side. It was clear that we must follow our ancestors' path. We selected four skilled individuals from across Hyrule and tasked them with the duty of piloting the divine beasts. With the princess as their commander, we dubbed these pilots champions, a name that would solidify their unique bond. The princess, her appointed knight, and the rest of the champions were on the brink of sealing away Ganon. But nay. Ganon was cunning, and he responded with a plan beyond our imagining. From deep below Hyrule Castle, seize control of the guardians and the divine beasts, and turn them against us. The champions lost their lives, those residing in the castle as well. The appointed knight, gravely wounded, collapsed while defending the princess. And thus, the kingdom of Hyrule was devastated absolutely by Calamity Ganon. However, the princess survived to face Ganon alone.
Link, you are our final hope. The fate of Hyrule rests with you.
That princess was my own daughter, my dear Zelda. And the courageous knight who protected her right up to the very end. That knight was none other than you, Link. You fought valiantly when your fate took an unfortunate turn. And then you were taken to the Shrine of Resurrection. Here you now stand, revitalized 100 years later. The words of guidance you have been hearing since your awakening are from Princess Zelda herself. Even now, as she works to restrain Ganon from within Hyrule Castle, she calls out for your help. However, my daughter's power will soon be exhausted. Once that happens, Ganon will freely regenerate himself, and nothing will stop him from consuming our land. Considering that I could not save my own kingdom, I have no right to ask this of you, Link. But I am powerless here. You must save her, my daughter, and do whatever it takes to annihilate Ganon. Somehow, Ganon has maintained control over all four divine beasts, as well as those guardians swarming around Hyrule Castle. I believe it would be quite reckless for you to head directly to the castle at this point. I suggest that you make your way east out to one of the villages in the wilderness. Follow the road out to Kakariko Village. There you will find the Elder Impa. She will tell you more about the path that lies ahead. Consult the map on your Sheikah slate for the precise location of Kakariko Village. Make your way past the twin summits of the dueling peaks. From there, follow the road as it proceeds north.